Hi everyone, today in this lesson we are going to learn about a physical quantity. So what is meant by a physical quantity? The quantity which can be measured directly or indirectly, and that is called a physical quantity. There are many physical quantities out there. A few examples are given here: mass, length, time, etc. Now these physical quantities are mainly divided into two, or there are two types of physical quantities. Which are the two types of physical quantity? The first one is that fundamental quantity. Fundamental quantity is also called base quantity. So what is meant by base quantity? The quantities which cannot be expressed in terms of simpler quantities. That means the fundamental quantity, the name implies, it is a fundamental or simpler quantities it is. Example, same example: mass, length, time, temperature, electric current, etc. I will learn detail later. The next type of physical quantity is the derived quantities. What is meant by derived quantities? Are those quantities which can be expressed in terms of simpler quantities. So which are simpler quantities? We have already discussed. So using simpler quantities, we can make a new quantity that can be derived by using simpler quantity. Example: area, volume, speed, acceleration, force, etc. Clear? So these are the physical quantities. Now look at the measuring process. Definitely for a physical quantity means that can be measured. So while we are measuring, definitely you already know what all things will be using, the different instrument will be using there. A simple example: for measuring length, you will be using measuring tape, correct? Or balance will be using to measure the mass, etc. So what is the measuring process? You can see here, measurement, a process of comparing the quantity with a standard amount of the physical quantity of the same kind. That means it's just a comparison with a known value. So once again, process of comparing the quantity with a standard amount of the physical quantity of the same kind. So to express the measurement, we require two things. The first one is unit in which the quantity is measured, and the next one is the numerical value or magnitude. So how to represent a physical quantity? A physical quantity can be represented as physical quantity is equal to, there will be a numerical value, into size of unit. This is the two things is required. Alright, just an example, or simply we can represent it as physical quantity Q is equal to a numerical value into unit. Just an example, just to measure the length of the room. Okay, length of room, maybe it is 5 meter. Here what is 5 represents? That is a numerical value, so that is n, and u represents what? The unit, right? Here it is given the meter is a unit. The same length of the room I can represent it as 500 centimeter. So what happened here? Length of the room is same, but the unit is different. Centimeter is the smallest unit, right? So what happened to the magnitude? Magnitude become higher. Meter is the highest unit, right? Where what happened to the magnitude? Magnitude is now less. So we can make a conclusion here. N is inversely proportional to U. That means unit, size of unit more, the numerical value will be less, and vice versa. Or we can write as nu is equal to constant. So for comparing the unit, we can write it as n1 u1, that is in one unit, is equal to n2 u2. So this is talking about measuring process. Move to the next one, system of units. What is meant by system of units? A complete set of units which is used to measure all kinds of fundamental and derived quantities. So usually we were using different types of units. We were using maybe French systems are the British system are the. So this is the two, three examples given. The one is CGS system. In CGS system, the unit for measuring length is centimeter, and for measuring mass is gram, and for time is second. In MKS system, length we are measuring with a meter, unit is meter, mass is in kilogram, time is in second. In FPS, it's a British system, length we are using the unit foot, and mass pound, and time second. But internationally accepted unit is the, that means all over the world, all the persons know an internationally accepted unit, and that is called SI unit. SI unit means what? The international system of units. So these are the three system of unit, and the internationally accepted system of unit is called what? SI system. Now let's move to the SI system. What is the SI system? In detail we will learn now. The SI system, fundamental quantities according to SI system. There are seven basic quantities are there. How many? There are seven basic physical quantities are there according to SI system. As you can see in the table, there are seven are the mass, length, time, temperature, amount of substance, and luminous intensity. Clear? So the symbol is not required. Just go to the SI unit name and symbol. That is important one. So mass, we are using the unit as kilogram, and that is representing kg. Length is in meter, representing m. Time second, representing s, small letter s. Current ampere, representing capital letter A. Temperature Kelvin, representing capital letter K. Amount of substance mole, mole, and symbol is mol. And luminous intensity, that's intensity of light, unit is candela, and the symbol is cd. So these are the seven basic physical quantity, or is called what? Fundamental quantity. Now let's discuss about the supplementary units. Other than seven basic physical quantity, we were studying the supplementary quantities. What are the supplementary quantities? Mainly we are discussing two supplementary quantities as well as supplementary units. The first one is called plane angle. So in order to explain the plane angle, we have to consider, just imagine one line you are drawing in your notebook, and one more line you are drawing in the notebook in such a way that both the ends are in contact. You can see the two lines are here now. These two lines make an angle theta. Two lines you have drawn in a plane, and that notebook page is just like a plane, and the angle made in between these two lines is called what? Plane angle. Now you just imagine these two lines are the part of a circle. Part of a circle. So I can mark it as this is O, and this is A, and this is B. If you take OAB, how to calculate the plane angle? So you can write here, plane angle is equal to, the formula you have to learn here, the plane angle can be calculated as arc length divided by radius. Arc length divided by radius. Here what is the radius? OA is the radius representing small r. OB is also representing radius small r. So the plane angle formula, theta is equal to, we can write the arc length. What is arc length here? AB. And what is the radius here? R. So this is the formula for calculating the plane angle. Now what is the unit of plane angle as radian? R-A-D-I-A-N. And we used to represent it as rad. What is that? Radian, or representing what? Rad. Which are the other units using for plane angle? That is, one is in degree, other one is in minute, Next one is in second. All right. So degree, minute, and second. So these are the units we were using for the plane angle. And the plane angle formula, theta is equal to arc length divided by radius. Now let's discuss one question here. What will be the angle in radian measured around a point? That means you just draw a point in your notebook. That means your notebook page is a plane actually. If you consider this as a point, around the point, I can consider around the point, if I join with the same radius, I can see there is a it is a circle, and circle you are drawing in your notebook in a plane. So this is a two-dimensional picture, and this is the radius r. Anywhere you draw, this will be the radius r. Question is talking about what is the total angle around the point. So I can use the formula here. Theta is equal to arc length. Arc length is same as what? Around this point, what is arc length? The circumference. What is the circumference of a circle? That is equal to 2 pi r divided by radius. Arc length divided by radius. Radius is what? R. So here you will get r cancel, and the plane angle theta around a point, you can write it as 2 pi radian. 2 pi radian, same as what? 2 pi rad. Now the other units we are using is the degree, right? So we can write here 360 degree is same as 2 pi rad. Conversion is required, so you should learn here 360 degree is equal to 2 pi rad. Or we can write the, if you divide by 2 the both side, you will get 180 degree is equal to pi rad. 1 minute, how to represents 1 minute? 1 minute you can write the one single dash. Okay, 1 minute is equal to 60 second. Written words, after that you can see 1 minute is equal to 60 second. Same way, just before that you learned the 1 degree is equal to 60 minute. A single dash represents what? Minute. So once again, 360 degree is equal to pi rad, 180 degree is equal to pi rad, 1 degree is equal to 60 minute, 1 minute is equal to 60 second. So these are the units we were using for plane angle. Okay. Now let's move to the next supplementary unit called solid angle. So to find a solid angle, you just imagine an imaginary figure, okay? That is not a two-dimensional one, it is a three-dimensional figure. Just imagine a sphere is shown here. So this is the center point here, say it as O at the midpoint. Just imagine you are taking a shape from that sphere. The shape is shown here, it is a cone shape. Take that cone from that sphere, you can see there is an angle shown here. We can represent it as d omega. What is that? D omega. And here this shaded one is already written the area. Right, so we can write here, we are not taking the entire area, we are taking a small area, so we can write it as small letter d into a. So d represents what? It's just small in the sense. So d omega, omega represents a solid angle, d represents what? A small angle, because we are not taking the entire one. Clear? So what is the solid angle formula? Solid angle is equal to, formula is here, area divided by radius square, or we can write the, in this picture, d omega is equal to a divided by r square. So this is a formula for solid angle. Now what is the unit of solid angle? We are using the unit of solid angle as steradian. Radian, steradian, and we are representing it as stare. So this is all about the solid angle. So just imagine, so just to think about, while you're discussing about the plane angle, we are drawing a two-dimensional figure. While you are considering the solid angle, the picture, the imaginary picture must be what? Three-dimensional. Okay. Now you just discuss this question. What will be the solid angle in steradian measured around a point? So imagine this is a point and you are considering around this point. What do you have to consider here? Is it a circle? No. You have to consider a sphere. Question is asking about what is the total angle, that is solid angle, around the point. So what is our formula here? Solid angle omega is equal to area divided by r square. For a sphere, what is the total area? So you can write here omega is equal to 4 pi r square divided by r square. R square cancel. So you will be getting the solid angle around a point as 4 pi steradian. 4 pi steradian. So this is talking about solid angle. I hope it is understood. Thank you.